flag is out, and we are racing. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here and live here at the Milwaukee Mile, getting ready for the second race of the WRLA Pepsi Cup Series. It is the Mello Yello 400. We go from the 2 mile racetrack of Michigan International Speedway to the short track of the Milwaukee Mile. This is going to be a very interesting night here in Milwaukee. Before we get into tonight's race, why don't we go ahead and take a look at our point standings coming into the second race of the season. It is Zachary Taylor that holds on to the points lead with 58 points. He managed to get every single bonus point nailed down. He not only got 42 points for finishing first, he led a lap, which is a bonus point. He led the most laps, 5 bonus points, and 10 bonus points for winning the race. Add that all together, you get 58. He holds on to that points lead. Quinton Moore, who finished runner-up, he is second in the points with 42 in the bag. Zachary Taylor, third with 40. Mitchell Collins, 39. Susie Atikian, 37. Reagan Whitlock with 34. Ray Atikian with 33. Wayne Lopez with 32. Allison Rain with 30. And Bob Floyd completes the top 10 of the point standings with 29 points in the bag. A couple drivers that I thought were actually going to get really good starts to their season, one of them being Alex Bonsinger, I thought was going to have a really great start to the year. He comes into this race 30th in the points with 7 points in the with 9 points in the bank. Audra Baranowski is another one, 30 with 29th for Bonsinger, 30th for Audra Baranowski, 7th points in the bank. And Walker Family Motorsports, another team that I thought would actually kind of shine a little bit. But, however, just unfortunately, Walker Family Motorsports not getting the start that they want. Their highest driver right now is C.G. Holt, who sits 26th in points with 12 points in the bank. Wyatt Walker second to last with 2. Gekka Holt 33rd with 4. And the driver that started the season off as the points leader 3 years ago in 2020, Derek Hamill, starts the season all the way on the other end of the point standings, dead last with 1 point in his pocket. That is a look at your point standings, and as you see the starting lineup roll on the left-hand side of your screen, you see on the front row that is the number 4 of Claire Phillips, who ended up making the race by finishing inside of 5th. In finishing inside of the top 6 by finishing 5th. She drew the pole position, and lining up alongside her is the number 90 of Dylan Abrahamian, a guy that Josh Tipton, who was up in the booth this past Sunday, picked as a guy to win. He managed to stay out of trouble throughout the most of the race, but unfortunately ended up getting taken out coming to the white flag in a last lap crash just shy of the finish. And Dylan Abrahamian looking to bounce back, with Oskin Motorsports making their second consecutive race, whether it be one or both of their cars in the show. And this is definitely going to be one that's going to be fun to watch. So why don't we get down to it? The drivers are strapped into their cars. Pre-race ceremonies have just now started to wrap up. But in order to get these 42 behemoths on the racetrack, we got to get the command to fire the engines.
Driver!
Engines are fired, pace car rolls off, and so will these 42 competitors. 100 laps of action here in Milwaukee. First night race of the season. That is first official points race held at night, just to clarify. Not including the clash at Kalamazoo back a couple weeks ago. This is definitely going to be a very fun one to watch. We're really glad that you're with us here at the Milwaukee Mile, the running of the Mello Yello 400. Row one once again with Phillips and Aberheimen making up the front row. Two part-timers, two red stripes on the front row. Then you have then two rookies, two yellow stripes of Tanner Parton and Bob Floyd making up the second row, and a pair of veterans making up the third row, the sophomore of Joshua Hyatt and the 66 of Emily Anderson. Pace car is in, and away we go for the second race of the season here in Milwaukee. Claire Phillips gets away on the start. Dylan Aberheimen had to just basically lost a lot of speed going through one and two, and he's now starting to fall back into the clutches of Tanner Parton, who takes over the second position. Joshua Hyatt is now going to go after Aberheimen for third. They race back down into turn number one. Hyatt lining, pulling up alongside. They slide up the racetrack just a little bit. And now Aberheimen is going to lose that third position to Joshua Hyatt. And that's going to also open the door for Gekka Hall. This is going to be a really perfect, this is honestly a really perfect time for some of these other drivers that are severely deep in the points innings. Like Gekka Hall, for instance, as I mentioned, just outside of the top 30 with 4 points in the bank. This is your perfect chance. This is the best chance at the early point of the season to gain as many spots as you possibly can, so that way you can move up as much as possible in the point standings, just to give yourself a little bit more of a solid cushion. And we got a caution on the racetrack. Trouble on the back straightaway. Elijah Gordon, heavy damage to his race car. Looks like he's been upside down. He is going to be out of this one. I also saw Audra Baranaskas pulling away from the scene. CG Holt once again. Another bad finish. This is going to put him a little bit deeper in the point standings. Actually, nope, he's staying out on the racetrack. Leading us back to the caution flag was Claire Phillips. So caution on the speedway with 3 laps complete. One of the cars I ended up seeing stopped on the back straightaway, of course, was Gordon. But another driver that was rolling very slowly was the two of Audra Baranauskas. And we've got some split strategies here. We got a lot of cars coming down pit road. Two staying out. Two, three cars staying out. That would be the number 90 of Dylan Aberheimen, the 11 of Bob Floyd, and also the 97 of Nathan Stapleton. Those three drivers are staying out on the racetrack, while the rest of the field comes on down into pit road. Unfortunately, Elijah Gordon is going to get knocked out very early in this one. And the troubles are definitely going to woe that number 77 once again for the second straight race here, this time at the Milwaukee Mile. Dylan Aberheimen right now is your race leader. Gekka Holt's going to come out first on the pit road. Emmanuel Hartnett will come out second. Claire Phillips falls back a couple spots. She gets kicked back to third coming out of the pits. Tanner Parton fourth. Then you have Joshua Hyatt coming out fifth. Coming out sixth was Colin Cropley. Seventh was Travis Crampton. Eighth, Derek Hamill. Ninth, Emily Anderson. And Reagan Whitlock came out 10th. But official position-wise, that would be Dylan Aberheimen, who's currently your race leader. So why don't we go back and take a look at what happened that caused our first yellow flag of the night here in the Mello Yello 400 here at the Milwaukee Mile. So Gordon wasn't the official driver that brought out the caution flag. However, he does play a part in this, as he is in the middle three wide. And this track is plenty wide enough for three wide, but it's not usually preferred. You're going to see here, Gordon is going to get sandwiched between CG Holt and Felix Jensen. Meanwhile, behind him, Wyatt Walker gets sandwiched in between Audra Baranauskas and Allison Rain. And Baranauskas gets turned off the nose of Wyatt Walker. And you see right here, CG Holt and Gordon get into the inside wall very hard. Hard into that inside wall. You see that 77 flipping upside down. Luckily, comes back to rest on all four wheels. We also see Baranauskas looping it around and coming back out. Well, not coming back out onto the racetrack, but more so getting her car refired and get it pointed back the right directions. That way she can continue on with this race. But troubles early for CG Hall, Elijah Gordon, Audrey Baranauskas, and more. Following along here with Elijah Gordon, this is pretty much going to be a common theme throughout this race here. Turn two, I'm seeing, is going to be a trouble spot. You see Baranauskas get turned off the nose of Wyatt Walker. You also see CG Hall and Elijah Gordon hitting that inside wall very hard. And that's what's going to knock Gordon out of the race. But turn two, I'm definitely going to be seeing as a trouble spot throughout a vast majority of the night. And it's kind of like what we saw with MIS. Usually turn two would be the trouble spot, but turn two is definitely going to be the trouble spot here tonight at MIS. But in the meantime, the number 90 of Dylan Abrahamian currently is your race leader. Why don't we go ahead and rejoin the field for the restart in the Mello Yolo 400, race number two of the WRLA Pepsi Cup Series. One lap and we will be back to green flag racing. Dylan Abrahamian currently is your race leader. Sitting in second is Bob Floyd. Third, Nathan Stapleton. Fourth, Gekka Holt. Fifth, Emmanuel Hartnett. Restarting in the sixth position, that would be Claire Phillips. Seventh, Tanner Parton. Eighth will be Joshua Hyatt. Ninth, Colin Cropley. And Travis Crampton will complete the top 10. You see CG Holt lining up on the inside line. He is two laps down on the racetrack, and the only retiree from the race is Elijah Gordon in the 77. He has smelled what the rock was cooking here as we come around through turns 3 and 4 this time by. Hopefully we get a little bit of a longer green flag run in as the pace car pulls off. And Dylan Abrahamian, the control car, is going to bring him back to the restart here in Milwaukee. And we're starting to see here that CG Holt a little bit slower on the racetrack. So it's going to be a little bit harder for some of these drivers to navigate their way around him as this race goes on here. But starting to see some side-by-side action. Look at Emily Anderson under attack from Reagan Whitlock. That would be the battle for the 12th position, actually. And it looks like Whitlock's going to get it off of turn number 4. Not quite clear of the 66 here, but definitely will be able to clear her as they come off of turn number 2. Anderson fighting back, but Whitlock is going to take the position away. And now we're starting to see some drivers have some troubles getting around CG Hall. Claire Phillips, definitely the perfect example of that one, as she gets held up by the 17. And this is going to cause some drivers to stack up, and that may cause another wreck. Going to have to watch for this here. Abrahamian is still the race leader. Ooh, are we going to go 3 wide? That is kind of the question that I'm really hoping is answered with a no. But everybody getting by perfectly just fine, at least for the time being. As we're going to refocus up at the front here for just a... In the meantime, so far, the top 3 have all checked out from Gekka Holt, who currently just sits comfortably in the 4th position. And everybody's still riding around single file. Not having to worry about too much here. John Andrews almost got turned by CG Hall coming off of turn number 2. And Andrews manages to hold on, but they are 3 wide here. CG up on the top. And they're going to get through 3 wide perfectly fine, but unfortunately this is going to hold up Joshua Hyatt by a lot as he starts to lose some positions here. Oh, this is going to be dangerous. Miller making contact with Joshua Hyatt. As now they're 3 wide once again. At this point, a lot of these drivers are losing patience with CG Holt right off the bat, so they are just hanging him out to dry here. How can you blame him, especially with his car just not being up to par, the speed of the car not being up to par with all the rest of these other drivers? You really can't blame them for wanting to get CG Holt out of the way so that way they don't have to worry about him for a little while longer. So 12 laps into this race. Coming around to complete 13 laps, Dylan Aberheimen still the race leader. Nothing much has changed since the drop of the green flag to restart the race. However, seeing as how the top three are on a different sequence from all the rest of the drivers who came down and pitted, it is going to be interesting to see. Oh, no! Whoa! There they go again! Luckily, nobody went around that time. So we stay green. C.G. Holden and Stephen Colon getting together. The three wide once again. And it looks like we're going to get through just fine. So now C.G. Holden has been cycled to the back of the field. I believe, damage to Jack Lagasse's car. I wonder if he tagged the wall a little bit ago, but top three have all checked out. Bob Floyd still sitting in that second position. He is at least 0.2 seconds behind Dylan Aberheimen. Nathan Stapleton also sitting comfortably in that third position. I believe he's also starting to close in ever so slightly on these on the front two. As now Stapleton has, he hasn't really gained or lost any whatsoever. He's kind of just sat perched right where he is right now. About five, well, he lost a hundredth there, but doesn't make too much of a difference. Gekka Holt right now looking on to those three cars that are starting to get wrapped up under a blanket. I wonder if Gekka's starting to make up some time as well. Stapleton gained 0.02. Gekka really didn't gain or lose anything out of that. She's kind of stayed right where she was. 1.1 seconds behind the leader, Dylan Aberheimen. That's just in relation to Dylan Aberheimen. She's 0.6 seconds back from Nathan Stapleton right now. So I wonder if her car is starting to come to life or if she's just trying to hang back, trying to save her stuff. That could potentially be the case. She gained a couple hundredths there in relation to the leader, Aberheimen, but right now she's kind of sitting comfortably right now in that fourth position. Dylan Emmanuel Hartnett right now is fifth on the board right now, and he was on track for, I'd say, a top 10 finish coming to the white flag, but unfortunately was involved in that in the incident that coming to the last lap at Michigan involving Jack Lagasse and quite a few others, and that's what, and he didn't get off to the season, to the proper start to the season that he wanted. He came into this race 13th in the standings, which is still not bad, but definitely something that Emmanuel Hartnett didn't want. He has 26 points in the bag, tied with Emily Anderson. Anderson right now sits 12th, so this will definitely be the tiebreaker right here between Hartnett and Anderson is where they finish in this race. We're a fifth of the way through here, and so far Dylan Aberheimen has led all but the opening 3 to 4 laps. We see Stapleton starting to close in on the back bumper of the 11 of Bob Floyd. He's right there, ready to pounce if Floyd makes a mistake. Going back down into turn number 3, Stapleton pulls up ever so slightly. To the line, it looks like that's still about 0.2 seconds. Exactly 0.2 seconds. Between Bob Floyd and Nathan Stapleton. And Gekka Holt pretty much is kind of staying right where she is. As I mentioned, she's not really in much of a hurry right now to get up to the front. I think she's probably waiting for this upcoming pit stop, upcoming round of green flag stops. That's only if we're green for long enough to where we actually have green flag stops, because the side-by-side racing that we're currently dealing with is over here towards the tail end of the pack with Wyatt Walker, Audra Baranowskis, Alex Bonsinger, and Zachary Taylor going at it. And Zachary Taylor way back here in the 39th position. This is definitely where he does not want to be, especially when you start off the season as the points leader. You dominate an MIS, you gain all the points that you can, you win the race, and now you get a really bad qualifying position, and you're having to reap the consequences of getting a really bad qualifying position by not gaining a whole lot of spots here. But it would be interesting to see if Zachary Taylor can pull off some sort of strategy on pit road, whether it be under a yellow flag stop or a green flag stop, so that way he can pick up a few positions and maybe see if he can lengthen his points lead or try to find some way to maintain the points lead heading into the next race at Canadian Tire. So definitely have to going to be something that we're going to have to watch here as we're a little over a quarter of the way through the Mello Yellow 400 here at the Milwaukee Mile. 26 laps complete. And now it's two, still 15 one-hundredths of a second between Floyd and Stapleton. They are nose to tail as Aberheimen is starting to check out. But you got to think here, if Dylan Aberheimen, Bob Floyd, and Nathan Stapleton are all on the same strategy, because remember, they stayed out on that first yellow flag pit stop. So chances are they might have to come down pit road right around the halfway point. And most likely the same could be said for all the other drivers, but maybe just a couple laps later from everybody else. They come around through turn number four. At least two. And now to the stripe. Pretty much the same gap, but we're also going to have to deal with slower traffic once again with CG Hall, who is pretty far off the pace from everybody else. We've seen it before where we almost had another yellow flag just with drivers trying to get by him, so that way they won't have to worry about him for a little while. And the same can be said for a driver like Jack Lagasse. The Lagasse right now is still pretty much up to par with all the rest of the other drivers, so he doesn't necessarily have to worry too much about going a lap down, unless if we go under possibly not really under caution, but more particularly about pit strategy. If he has a different pit strategy than everybody else, then yes, I could understand him being concerned about going a lap down. But since he's up to par with everybody else, not necessarily. He's about 6 seconds back from 38th place, well, now 39th place of Audra Baranowskis. So it's definitely going to be interesting to see how this upcoming round of green flag stops is going to turn out. As 31 laps are complete, we are 3/10 of the way through. We haven't seen a yellow flag since lap number 3. And Dylan Aberheimen still currently your race leader. If you're just joining us, we have only had one caution flag on lap number 3. But ever since we took the restart, only three drivers within that last caution period. Everybody came down pit road with the exception of Dylan Aberheim in the 90, Bob Floyd in the 11, and Nathan Stapleton in the 97. Those three drivers stayed out on track, and they are currently first, second, and third. Gekko Holt on back went into the pits to get four tires and fuel. So Gekko Holt sits fourth. Emmanuel Hartnett fifth. Sixth is Tanner Parton. Seventh is teammate Colin Cropley. Eighth, Derek Hamill, who actually is going to get himself a really good points day if he can hold on to that eighth spot. Ninth is Travis Crampton, and Reagan Whitlock completes the top 10. And remember, Reagan Whitlock comes into this race Reagan Whitlock comes into this race sixth in the standings. And she's currently 10th right now, so if she can actually get another top 10 finish, definitely going to be a really great way to say, hey guys, I'm back in the WLA for the first time since in a while, and I have not lost a beat. So definitely would be really great to see a driver like Reagan Whitlock, who initially had her own team of Reagan Whitlock Motorsports, had the primary sponsor of the Angry Birds Star Wars as the primary sponsor, and what her initial car was the number 33. Now here she is driving for Cologne Motorsports, and if this race does go green the rest of the way and she can actually nail her pit strategy, she would have definitely get another top 10, move herself up in the point standings just a little bit more, and she might have herself a really good couple points races to start off the 2023 season. See here, she's looking to the inside of Travis Crampton. That is for the ninth spot. See if she's going to get it coming off of turn number four, side by side. Whitlock gets it at the line. Is she going to get it coming? Is she going to clear Crampton coming off of turn number two? Crampton fighting back. And she's got it. Clear of the 61 of Crampton. Now Crampton gets kicked back to 10th. Now that was honestly some really good clean racing between those two. And Crampton definitely saw, all right, Whitlock's got a faster car. I'm going to let her go. And I'm just going to run my race. True racing veteran there for Travis Crampton. Whether it be NR 2003, iRacing, real life, he definitely knows what he's doing. It's Derek Campbell. As I mentioned, he started the race, started the 2020 season as the points leader. This year, on the opposite end of the spectrum, dead last in points with a single point in the bank for him. But as I mentioned, a really good points day can definitely turn it all around for him. And if he finishes in this eighth position, he would definitely catapult himself up. I'd say probably around maybe the top 20 in the points standings, top 15. At best, top 10, if he were to lead a lap. Say if he stayed out on a round of green flag, on this upcoming round of green flag pit stops, and got himself a lap led. Who knows? He might end up inside of the top 15 of the point standings, maybe top 10, if we want to get bold here. But in order for him to possibly get inside of the top 10 in the point standings, he'd have to win the race, of course. So definitely going to be something we're going to watch here for once we get to this upcoming round of green flag stops, which should be right around the halfway point. Gekka's starting to close in a little bit. Remember, she was 1.1 seconds back relevant to the the gap between herself and the leader, Dylan Abraheimen. But now Abraheimen and everybody else, we're going to have to start dealing with the 17, the slower traffic. We've now caught CG Holt. Abraheimen gets by flawlessly. Stapleton is going to get down to the inside. Gekka's going to follow. But that was just enough to pull Gekka right into the mix. And now we have ourselves a three-car fight for second place. But I'm also really surprised that nobody really has made a move up inside of the top five. Everybody's been mostly single file, nose to tail. Not a lot of action up at the front of the field, but everybody's single file also a little bit further up, further back inside of the top 10. But it's so, and they're also catching up to CG Holt. So these drivers are. So we're just gonna have to see what lines that they take to try to get by. And we got ourselves green flag pit stops coming up here. Dylan Abraheimen goes to pit row. That's going to give the lead to Bob Floyd in the number 11. We see Dylan Abraheimen in the 90. Remember, outside pulls hitter comes down pit road. I was trying to get to him, but I couldn't. for some reason. Now we're going to start seeing Bob Floyd and Nathan Stapleton give up their second and third place positions to come to pit road. They do just that. That gives the lead over to Gekka Holt in the 27. And now we're starting to see some drivers get held up by C.G. Holt. Tanner Parton is the unfortunate victim to this one, as now he starts to lose a lot of positions. He went from what was sixth to third, now back all the way back now to fourth. Now he's going to fall all the way back to the seventh position. So now we're starting to see some racing here. Thought Colin Cropley was going to try to go around Emmanuel Hartnett on the outside. Unfortunately, was not able to get the job done. But I do expect the this round of green flag pit stops to really kick into high gear once these drivers start to come down pit road. Like I said, right around the halfway point, maybe just shy of halfway. But Emmanuel Hartnett now moves up into the second position after those three drivers came down pit road. So this is definitely going to be very interesting here, because now if a caution were to come out once these drivers come down pit road, that is definitely going to throw a huge monkey wrench into this one, and it will definitely shake up the points, but that is if the race were to end. But it's definitely going to shake up the running order if we were to have yet another caution flag in this race. Never really say never here. It could definitely happen. Race leader, Gekka Holt, comes down to pit. Emmanuel Hartnett follows. From Colin Cropley down back to Tanner Parton, they all stayed out. Wyatt Walker is in and away. So is Audrey Baranowskis. Felix Jensen comes in. Mitchell Collins. Also see Henry Williams in. Noah Clifton, Braden Perez. And a lot of other drivers are on pit road as well, including points leader Zachary Taylor. Now here comes Colin Cropley, Derek Hamill into the pits. Followed by John Andrews, Wayne Lopez, Bronson Minnick, Allison Rain, Al Lagasse, Abby Walker, Joshua Hyatt. Those drivers are on pit road. So now Reagan Whitlock leads at the halfway point, and these drivers are set to come down pit road. So here comes Reagan Whitlock. She's going to lead Travis Crampton and Tanner Parton into the pits. Michael Ramsey, Nia Steidl, Emily Anderson, Bradley Bradshaw, Andrew Miller, Ray Atikian, Zachary Fitzwater, William Brock. And that should be the rest of the field. So the lead right now, that should be the rest of the field, but I'm not 100% sure because I haven't seen Claire Phillips and Susie Atikian in the pits, and now here they come. So now that will be all of the drivers that have already made their green flag stops, and have already made a visit down pit road. So the lead may possibly go back into the hands of Dylan Aberheimen. Stapleton may sit in that, maybe in second, and Bob Floyd, or more than likely, will be third. So this is going to be very interesting here. Let's see if this is going to be the official running order. Coming across the line, that is definitely going to be the case here, because now they have just gone by Claire Phillips and Susie Atikian. So now that will put Dylan Aberheimen back into the lead, with Nathan Stapleton second. Oh no! John Andrews sideways on the back straightaway, gathers it back up, but that is gonna bring out a caution flag. Oh boy, everybody going really wide here. Claire Phillips almost got turned, but that is another caution flag. We just saw that happen live. And we are re-racking them up, and we are restarting them all up again. Wow. We just saw that live. That, thankfully was not as bad as what I thought it was going to be. So a similar situation that we just saw, similar to what we saw last race, well, last caution flag. But not as bad though. Thankfully, John Andrews was, even though he went sideways, luckily got straightened back out. Minimal damage to the car. We see everybody coming back down pit road, changing tires, and we're starting to see some more strategy out of some of these drivers. Colin Cropley ends up staying out, and that's going to give him the race lead. Reagan Whitlock also stays out with Tanner Parton, Emily Anderson, Michael Ramsey, Claire Phillips, Jack Lagasse, who remember is a lap down. Abby Walker also stayed out with Zachary Fitzwater, Susie Atikian, and others. So this definitely is going to shake up the running order for sure. Colin Cropley is going to be the race leader. So some very split strategies is what's going to shake up the running order. Let's go back and look at that John Andrews spin that brought out our second caution flag of the night. So this is basically a similar scenario to what we saw back on lap 3 with Elijah Gordon, Wyatt Walker, CG Hold, and others at the very beginning of the race. But here we are, similar scenario, but not as many cars around here. We got Mitchell Collins on the bottom. He just shoots it coming out of turn number 2. That moves him up into Michael Ramsey, who then gets into John Andrews. And that sends Andrews' car 90 degrees, nose pointed to the inside wall, but luckily saves the car. And a lot of good heads-up driving by some of these other guys to just go around on the inside and outside, but it started to get a little bit messy here once they got into turn number 3. As we see a lot of drivers scattered all over the racetrack. Top, bottom, left sides in the grass for Allison Rain. But trouble just past the halfway point. Luckily, we didn't have any other further incidents. So looks like we are 100% good to go here for the restart at the Milwaukee Mile. So this is looking back from Tanner Parton's machine. Watch as the 42 slides up the hill. That opens the door for Collins to drive to the inside. Slides up into Ramsey and then gets into Andrews. And there's that 90 degree spin. Man, though, just think if some of those drivers didn't quite make it through, that would have been a way worse than what it was. But thankfully, everybody's cars are mostly clean. Colin Cropley is your race leader. So why don't we go ahead and get to the restart here for the Mello Yello 400 at the Milwaukee Mile. One lap and we will be back to green flag racing here at the Milwaukee Mile after some very split strategies. This puts Colin Cropley in the lead with Reagan Whitlock second, Tanner Parton third, Emily Anderson fourth, Michael Ramsey fifth, Claire Phillips 6th, Abby Walker 7th, Zachary Fitzwater 8th, Susie Atikian 9th, and Bradley Bradshaw completing the top 10. A very, very different look of what the top 10 looks like. And you see here, down on the inside once again, CG Holt now joined by Jack Lagasse, who was a lap down. CG is now 3 laps down in that Black Veil Brides number 17. So now we're going to have a little bit more of a challenge. So now these drivers are going to have a little bit more of a challenge just trying to get around the slower traffic here. Pace cars off. Cropley, the control car, brings them back down to the green to start lap number 58. Now this is definitely going to be something we're going to have to watch for here. Holt drives it up the track, almost into Tanner Parton. But Parton is going to get away from CG Holt here. I wonder if Michael Ramsey's going to try to drive it to the inside. Not going to do it here. They come off of turn number four. Man, I thought CG was going to tuck it up right in front of Emily Anderson, but Anderson just mashes the gas coming off of turn number four and pulls away from CG Holt. Now Abby Walker, CG's teammate. Oh, no! There goes Susie sideways. Saves it, but Emmanuel Hartnett into the wall. They stack it up going into turn number four. Collins around, involving two of the Derek Hamill racing cars. Wayne Lopez gets collected. And a huge accident going into turn number three is going to take out a few more cars, and we're back under yellow just like that. Wow. Wayne Lopez, heavy damage to his race machine. He is going to be out of this one. Mitchell Collins is going to join him. Two out of the three Hamill Racing cars got collected in that mess. Bob Floyd, who is having himself a pretty good run, unfortunately is going to be out of it. Derek Hamill, heavy rear end damage after backing his car into the inside wall very hard. Man, so much happened there within a short period of time. Just difficult to keep up with it. We see Emily Anderson on pit road with Colin Cropley. Reagan Whitlock also came down to pit. Michael Ramsey, Ray Atikian, William Brock, Nathan Stapleton came into the pits. And that's going to give the lead over to the 79 of Tanner Parton. So why don't we go back and take a look at that third yellow flag that has brought this race to a halt here at the Milwaukee Mile. So this kicked into high gear here with Susie Atikian in the middle, Claire Phillips up top, and Bradley Bratshaw on the bottom. Looks like Susie might have... Well, that's what happened right there. William Brock came up into the left rear quarter panel of Susie, got her sideways, and that slight tap from Brock's car managed to save Susie. However, Hartnett and Derek Hamill get into the wall. Mitchell Collins gets a piece of this, and they're all at this point, everybody is stacked up here going into turn number three. They are five wide for a split second, and then Collins gets into Derek Hamill, and who then gets into Bob Floyd. So that's three cars in the wall. Josiah Munsell gets a piece, but he goes by. Wayne Lopez, not a fortunate victim of this scenario. Neither is Quinton Moore. Remember, Moore is runner-up in the point standings. Noah Clifton almost gets through that. Scott Free. Wyatt Walker might have a slight buckle on the hood, but not a whole lot of damage for his number 19. Same could be said for Noah Clifton, even though he got kind of slightly tapped there. Even though he slightly tapped somebody else. I think that might have been Wayne Lopez going into turn number four there. But man, lots of trouble here in the closing stages of this race here in Milwaukee. So looking at this at speed, Susie Atikian gets sandwiched and then turns sideways. Manages to save the car, but it just causes a huge stack up and everybody trying to scatter, trying to avoid all these other cars. It just creates another incident involving one Trinity River Racing car, two Hamill Racing Enterprises car, a Q-Man Motorsports car, Wayne Lopez's machine, an NS Racing car slightly, but not too much damage to the 99, but it's also going to end a couple of other drivers' days, unfortunately, here at Milwaukee. And Quinton Moore is definitely going to take a huge hit in the point standings. Same could be said for Mitchell Collins and also Wayne Lopez, as they will be taking their cars back behind the wall to end their nights early. This is from Wayne Lopez's perspective. He was way in the back when the first amount of trouble happens. And then the second amount of trouble right here. He gets into the side of Quintmore just a bit, but almost had that cleared. If Mitchell Collins was just a few, maybe just at least a foot or two higher up on the racetrack, he definitely would have made it through just fine. But unfortunately, that just was not the case, and this is going to knock Wayne Lopez out of the race here in Milwaukee. From Derek Hamill's on board. There's so much that happened right there just in those few seconds. That is just absolutely unreal what we just saw there. But one more on board, this time with the 19 of Wyatt Walker. Unlike a few of these other drivers that weren't so fortunate to make it through, Wyatt Walker was a very fortunate driver to make it through. This is the first incident, and now here comes the second incident. Gets on the brakes. Just barely touches the zero of Quintmore, but keeps on going. So Wyatt's going to definitely have a pretty good chance of capitalizing in the point standings. Remember, he comes into this race second to last in points with 2 points in his pocket. If he can manage to hold on and try to get a good finish, he's definitely going to have himself a really good points day heading into the next race in Canada. And in the meantime, Tanner Parton is going to be your race leader. So why don't we go ahead and join the field for the restart, the Mello Yello 400 here in Milwaukee. The field has just taken one to go, and we are set to go back under the green flag. Tanner Parton is shown as the race leader. However, Jack Lagasse, when he stayed out on the racetrack, managed to get back on the lead lap. So now he is on the tail end of the lead lap. However, with the amount of speed that he has in his car, I don't expect that to last very long. So we're going to have to watch this restart, seeing as how his speed is definitely not up to par with everybody else's. CG Holt's going to join him on the inside line. And here's your top 10 coming to the restart. Tanner Parton, the leader. Abby Walker, second. Third is Zachary Fitzwater. Fourth, Bradley Bradshaw, the only other Hamill Racing Enterprises car in contention for this win. Claire Phillips, fifth. Sixth, Gekka Holt. Seventh, Emmanuel Hartnett. Eighth, Susie Atikian. Ninth, Stephen Colon. And Josiah Munsell completes the top 10. Here we go. Jack Lagasse actually did get a pretty good jump on that restart. But now here comes the trouble. Once again, just trying to figure out ways to get by the 17. Zachary Fitzwater gets held up there for at least a moment. And he's still going to get held up as that bottom line has not opened up. The red seas have not opened up just yet, but he's going to make that opening right there as he jumps to the inside of CG Holt and goes by him as they go into turn number one. But they're starting to stack up a little bit more. As now, oh boy. And Emmanuel Hartnett gets almost turned by Stephen Colon. Luckily saves it. We're still green. Nobody went into the inside wall. We're still racing. Thankfully, still racing. Parton checks out from Zachary Fitzwater, at least for the moment. Bradley Bradshaw still sitting in third with at least a third of a second behind. We're still watching to see if drivers are still going to try to get by CG Holt. Abby Walker jumps low on her teammate. She has fallen from second all the way back to seventh and then some. She's fallen outside of the top 10. Nope, still holding on to the inside of the top 10. This time in the 10th position. Oh boy, this is kind of dangerous here. Just seeing a lot of these drivers just come out of turn number two, or really corner exit, as close as they are. But everybody minding their own P's and Q's, at least for the moment. Still some pretty good side-by-side racing further in the back. But meanwhile, Tanner Parton still pulling away from Fitzy. Now 2/3 of a second. Susie Atikian, remember, she had her car sideways at least for a moment, but managed to save her car thanks to a little assist from William Brock. And now she's up, back up inside of the top five. Remember, she finished, I believe, 6th or 7th at MIS this past Sunday. So if she finishes inside of the top five again, there's a chance that she's definitely going to move herself up a little bit more in the point standings and may, just may, be the new points leader. Caution on the speedway once again. Trying to see where exactly the trouble might be. I wonder if another car went down in the inside wall. Either that or maybe it may have gone sideways. I do see some smoke, so there might have been another driver that probably got turned. We'll just have to figure that out. Now let's, but we've been kind of seeing a common theme here under these yellow flags, where some drivers will come in and some will stay out and take the race lead. Is Gekka Holt going to do that? She is not staying with the leaders, and she's going to do just that. The top three come down pit road. Abby Walker is going to join them. See if any other drivers are going to come down pit road. I do not see any others making their way to the pits. So now the lead is going to get turned over to Gekka Holt in the 27. And Susie Atikian will be in the second position once we get prepped up for the restart. So why don't we go ahead and review what would be our 4th caution flag of the night here in Milwaukee. Gekka Holt, your race leader. A bad night for Derek Hamill has just turned worse. But luckily, fortunately, this happened in the back. And I pretty much called it right on the dot. Turn 2 was going to be the trouble spot here. See Ramsey and William Brock get together. Prior to that, Brock was already into the left rear of Derek Hamill. So either way, he was going around. But Derek Hamill loops it and is going to save it and continue on here in this race. But, man, just a bad night has gone worse here for Derek Hamill in the closing stages of this race. One more time at speed before we get to the restart. See William Brock get into the left rear quarter panel. Michael Ramsey tags him, tags William Brock, which forces him up a little bit more into Hamill's car. Derek Hamill looped it around and almost got hit from the back by his own teammate at one of his own cars, Bob Floyd, but they managed to keep it together. Derek Hamill still in the race, but it's definitely, so far, still not a good night for Derek Hamill, but no further debris is on the racetrack, so we are 100% good to go. So why don't we get to the restart here in the Milwaukee Mile. One to go, and we will be ready to go green flag racing here at the Milwaukee Mile with 27 laps to go this time by. Gekka Holt is your race leader with Susie Atikian sitting in second, Claire Phillips third, Emmanuel Hartnett fourth, Travis Crampton completes the top five with the sixth spot being Stephen Cologne, seventh, the 29 of Felix Jensen, eighth, Alex Bonsignor, 9th, the 3 of Joshua Hyatt, and Henry Williams completes the top 10 coming to the restart. Same two drivers lined up down on the inside. And we're going to re-rack them up and try it again. And let's see how much further, if we can get a longer green flag run. Longer green flag run in. I don't even know what I'm saying. But anyways, pace car is in. Gekka Holt leads him back to the green. Gets a pretty good jump. Excuse me. Have to take a drink of water there. Lagacy moves up second in line. But Susie is going to answer back, but trying to get to the inside. Couldn't make the run quite work there. So Susie's going to tuck in third in line. And now is going to go for the pass on the inside. Now is going to go for the pass on the inside of Jack Lagasse. So now Lagasse is now trapped on the outside, at least for a little while longer. Travis Crampton moving up into the... And now we got a caution back out on the racetrack once again. This time it looks like Tanner Parton is spun. Man. I also see some damage to the 18 of Abby Walker. Oh man, oh man. Just lots of trouble towards the end of this one. Hopefully turning out to be a wreck fest, if that. But nonetheless, now let's see what the strategy looks like this time around. Looks like Claire Phillips is not going to join anybody else down in the pits. Or will she? No. Gekka, I thought, was going to join Susie Atikian in the pits. Not the case. Atikian comes down pit road. And it looks like nobody else is going to follow. So now, Gekka Holt retains the lead once again. So why don't we go back and take a look and see what happened that caused our fifth caution of the night here in Milwaukee. So once again, a very similar scenario. Three wide usually is just not the answer, especially if it's in the back of the field. Abby Walker and Bob Floyd getting together, but the trouble's really going to start once Tanner Parton gets into this. All three drivers clobber the wall, but Parton gets the worst end of that one as he goes for a couple 360s. Floyd and Walker were able to drive away, but Tanner Parton just kept going around and around and around, and he manages to get his car refired, and he is now driving away from the accident. But man, just we're having ourselves a major wreck fest. Closing in on 20 laps to go here in the Milwaukee Mile. So you see here, Floyd moves up a little bit too high, and Abby Walker also drives into the corner a little bit too hard. I think she might have hit the throttle a little bit too hard on corner exit and just kept riding into the 11's door. And then I think Parton tried to do the same thing, and that was just the final blow to that little spiel. But luckily everybody is still keeping it straight. We're still good to go. So why don't we rejoin the field for the restart here in the Mello Yello 400 in the Milwaukee Mile. One lap and we will be back to green flag racing here at the Milwaukee Mile. Right now, Gekka Holt right now is your race leader. Only one car came down the pit. That was Susie Atikian, so that will move everybody else up behind Holt one spot. Phillips to second. Then Crampton to the third. Cologne fourth. Bonsinger fifth. Williams sixth. Seventh. The 29 of Felix Jensen. Eighth, Allison Rain. Ninth, Emmanuel Hartnett. And the 3 of Joshua Hyatt completes the top 10. As we're reaching 20 laps to go this time by. Well, really 21 to go when they take the green flag, but we're just a couple laps away from 20 laps to go. Lights are out on the pace car, and pace car is on pit road, so let's re-rack them up. Let's try it again. Let's see how far we can go with this one. Green flag. Holt gets a good jump on that restart. But now Claire Phillips looks like she's starting to slip back a little bit. Lagasse still trying to fight back on the inside. Travis Crampton following in the tire tracks of the 4. And we're 3 wide coming off of turn number 4. This is dangerous. And they're still 3 wide with Cologne up top. Williams in the middle. Allie Rain on the bottom. Oh, that's dangerous. That's actually really tight, but luckily they managed to keep it straight. We're still green. And we didn't have another wreck with 20 laps to go. Now 19 once they cross the stripe this time by. Gekka Hall is checked out from Claire Phillips. But hopefully this green flag run lasts all the way to the checkered flag, but might have just jinxed it here. Hopefully I didn't, but we're just going to have to wait and see here. Everybody's still having a little bit of struggles just trying to get by C.G. Hall as he's holding up the outside line. Everybody down on the inside starting to get by pretty cleanly. Braden Perez goes by. So does Wyatt Walker. Oh, John Andrews forces his hand into there. Three wide, and now, oh boy, what is going on here? Four wide. That's not going to work. Around goes Reagan Whitlock. Sideways in front of the field. And just like that, we're back under caution. That is our sixth yellow flag of the night. I don't even know what was going on there. It just looked like that Whitlock just sent it in there. And when she did, she got up into Noah Clifton. And that slowed both of them down, and that opened up the door for four wide for just a split moment. That could have been way worse, but luckily nobody got severely, no, there was no severe pileups in that one. Now let's see what happens here with less than 15 laps to go. Well, 16 to go this time by. And it looks like nobody comes down pit road. So no changes on the leaderboard with the exception of what just happened there with Reagan Whitlock and as well as Noah Clifton and a few other drivers. But other than that, no major changes. Gekka Hall, the race leader. Why don't we go back and review that crash that brought out our sixth yellow flag of the night here in Milwaukee for the WRLA Pepsi Cup Series race number 2. So I'm not sure 100% of what just happened here, but we're going to see going into turn number 1. Whitlock forces it in underneath of Noah Clifton, just carrying way too much speed going through the corner. She slides up and Noah Clifton pretty much just goes up high with her. After all that speed that the 9 carried into the 99, and then from here, Dylan Aberheimen, really no place to go, gets into the left rear of Whitlock's car and sends her around, but with a little bit of assistance from Al Lagasse, manages to straighten the car back out before it would ever hit the inside wall, which it didn't. She did not hit the inside wall. That car got straightened out and she's still going with minimal damage, but even over here, going through turns 3 and 4, coming to the caution flag, that could have been so much worse than what it already may could have been. But nonetheless, everybody's still running, and I don't even know what else to say. But thankfully, Reagan Whitlock is still able to continue on in this race. So you see Reagan Whitlock force it into the corner, way too hard. That allows Whitlock and Clifton to walk up the racetrack. They were four wide for a split second. And that tap from Dylan Aberheimen sent the 9 around for a moment, but Al Lagasse straightened Whitlock back out. Unfortunately, she does not hit the inside wall, and she is still racing and is definitely going to see the finish of this one. So Gekka Hall currently is still your race leader. So why don't we rejoin the field for the restart, closing in within 15 laps to go, closing in on 10 laps to go here in Milwaukee. 13 laps to go when we restart here at the Milwaukee Mile. It is the 27 of Gekka Hall still leading. Some changes inside of the top 10. Phillips still second, Crampton still third, Bonsinger moves up to fourth, Felix Jensen completes the top 5. And it's Allison Rain finishing, in the sixth position, restarting in sixth, rather. Seventh will be the 31 of Henry Williams. Eighth will be Joshua Hyatt. Andrew Miller, haven't talked a whole lot about him. He's now up inside of the top 10. In the ninth position, and Emmanuel Hartnett completes the top 10. Andrew Miller's just been very quiet in this race. Not making a whole lot of noise, but he's making noise when it matters the most towards the end of the race, and he's going to be restarting in that ninth position. So it should be interesting to see how this restart plays out and if we can make it to the checkered flag under green flag conditions. Let's find out. Hopefully we don't have another race end under yellow flag conditions. Here we go. Gekko Holt gets a pretty good jump on that restart. Jack Lagasse fights back. He's trying to get back on the lead lap once again. He pulls out ahead. But Gekka fighting back on the top side. At least for the moment. Oh boy, and now Lagasse pulls out ahead. So Lagasse just might be able to get back on the lead lap. Maybe not, actually. Holt gets a great run on the exit of turn number four and will clear the 38. And we'll have smooth sailing out front. Meanwhile, Travis Crampton all over the back bumper of the four of Phillips here. That will be the battle for the second spot. As we race off of turn number four, 11 laps to go. As now Phillips is going to try to get by the 38 of Lagasse and try to set her sights on race leader Gekko Holt, looking back in through the field. A little bit more trouble trying to get by C.G. Hall. The Emmanuel Hartnett jumps low and will capitalize on that position. Bronson Minnick, with a slight buckle on his hood, is now moving up inside of the top 10. Look at that. That's another driver we really haven't talked about a whole lot in this race. Bronson Minnick, and now he's making noise when it matters most with 10 laps to go. Wyatt Walker also doing the same thing. Walker now up inside of the top 10. Remember, he came into this race second to last in points, and if he held on to maybe get a good finish, he would definitely have himself a really good points day and move well up in the points standing. So right now, ninth place, doing an excellent job. I think he's definitely going to get it if we go green the rest of the way. Same could be said for Alex Bonsignor in this number 22. Remember, Bonsignor came into this race 29th in points with 9 points in the bag. So a fourth place finish is definitely going to help with that. Caution on the speedway once again. This time it's a much bigger accident. Zachary Fitzwater, heavy damage to his Pertec machine. Stephen Cologne with some damage. William Brock, not a lot of damage to his race car, but he should definitely be okay to see the checkered flag fall in this one. Fitzy, unfortunately, will be taking his car back behind the wall a little bit earlier than expected. So caution flies within 10 laps to go. This will be a very interesting finish to this one. Gekka is going to stay out. Claire will stay out. Crampton stays out. So will Bonsignor, Allison Rain, and a few others. Pretty much everybody, with the exception of possibly the three cars. Well, Felix Jensen's got damage to his race machine, so he's going to come down into the pits. Heavy nose damage, moderate nose damage, actually, to the 29. But nonetheless, trouble within 10 laps to go is going to take out Zachary Fitzwater for the running of this one. So why don't we go back and see what happened that caused our seventh caution of the night here in Milwaukee. Time was running out, and of course we're going to see drivers going for what they could for as much real estate as possible. You see Zachary Fitzwater trying to get underneath of points leader Zachary Taylor. And looks like Fitzy carried a little bit too much speed right there, but you see Jensen actually get pushed up by Stephen Cologne, and Cologne actually got turned up into the outside wall right there. But also That collected the 98 of Fitzy. You see Zachary Taylor get into the outside wall. But William Brock, good heads-up driving for him. He just basically came to a complete stop, just trying to salvage what he can with his car, but manages to just nudge the right rear quarter panel of Fitzy, just trying to get by. But trouble's very late in the going, inside of 10 laps to go. That's going to take out Zachary Fitzwater and maybe a couple others from contention of either winning or possibly getting a good finish out of this. So this time, following along with Stephen Colon, this mostly just had to do with just trying to get by CG Holt. Man, so much happened within just a split second. And some of the drivers trying to get by the incident, like Fitzy, and like Taylor, and also Colin Cropley, got into the outside wall. Just as Colon and Fitzy and got some pretty heavy damage to their race cars, and that Pertec Chevy is definitely toast at that point. At this rate, William Brock's going to be okay to continue. I think even Tanner Parton just hit the outside wall. That actually happened? Hold on. Oh, boy. So this was actually on the cooldown lap. Baranauskas gets turned to the inside wall, but I think Tanner Parton might have squeezed Lagasse up into the outside wall, kept riding him into that outside wall until he got put into the turn one wall. I don't even know what's going on there, but I'm thinking there's probably going to be a fight in the pit area once this race is over. I think even Audra Baranauskas in the two. Heavy damage to the driver's side of her car, so she's definitely going to have to get some damage repaired on that race machine, but nonetheless, Gekka Holt is your race leader inside of 10 laps to go. Let's rejoin the field for the restart to see how the finish of this one's going to play out. So they will restart with 4 laps to go here at the Milwaukee Mile. Holt, your race leader, running in second, Claire Phillips, Crampton, Bonsignor, Rain, the top 5. Hyatt, Minnick, Hartnett, Walker, and Miller complete the top 10. And remember, with a single fight with within 10 laps to go, the rule is no cars that are a lap down or more line up on that inside line. So we're going to have a complete single file restart coming to the green flag. So this is definitely going to make getting by the slower traffic a little bit more of a challenge. But I see that challenge definitely being a little bit difficult for some of the other drivers closer to the back of the field. So we're just going to have to keep that in mind here. Pace car is in. Gekka Holt out front. Can she win in her second start? Green flag. We're just going to have to find that out. 4 laps of racing to go. Phillips sitting in the second position. Third right now, Travis Crampton. He's going to have himself a really good points day. And same could be said for Alex Bonsignor. They come to 3 to go. So far, no caution. With 3 laps of racing to go, we got a couple cars coming onto pit road. Derek Hamill's in, so is Stephen Colon. But that's not going to change anything towards the front of the field. So far, nobody's having any sort of challenges trying to get by CG Holt, at least for the moment. And they come to 2 laps of racing to go. Oh, wait a minute. Travis Crampton's coming down pit road. So pit strategy is definitely going to play a huge factor into who wins this race. I see Wyatt Walker coming down pit road with Al Lagasse joining him. Oh, boy. Is Gekka Holt going to roll the dice and try to make this last all the way to the finish? We're coming to the white flag. 1 more lap of racing to go here at the Milwaukee Mile. She's going to roll the dice. Claire Phillips in her debut right there to pounce if Gekka is not able to make it to the finish. They're down the back straightaway one last time. I think Gekka's got this. Going through turns three and four. Gekka really needed a good point stay to try to turn her season around to start out. And she's going to get it. Gekka Holt in her second start is going to win here at the Milwaukee Mile. Wow. Great race all the way to the finish, despite that wreckfest right in between towards the second half of this race. But nonetheless, Gekka Holt was able to make it work all the way to the end. She wins the race. Claire Phillips will finish in second. Third will be that number seven of Allison Rain. Fourth will be Joshua Hyatt. Fifth, Alex Bonsinger completed the top five. Then sixth will be the number 82 of Bronson Minnick. Seventh will be the number 20 of Emmanuel Hartnett. Eighth, Andrew Miller. Ninth, Braden Perez. And completing your top 10 will be the 97 of Nathan Stapleton. It looks like we've got ourselves a stack up coming onto pit road, but looks like Stapleton might have just tacked that inside pit, that pit wall, but luckily this is just a video game, so he'll be all right. The race is over nonetheless. You see the finishing results on the left-hand side of your screen from 11th to 42nd. Man, really good racing that we've seen here at the Milwaukee Mile, despite the fact that, yes, we did have a wreck fest closer to the round, the second half of this race. The racing itself really did not disappoint too much, and Gekka Holt manages to hold on. She makes the fuel hold up, and she's going to victory lane in her second WRLA Pepsi Cup Series start. Walker Family Motorsports is definitely getting their stuff turned around here, at least for the most part, with Gekka Holt nabbing her first career victory. So that is two drivers, two races in a row that we've had two first-time winners. Zachary Taylor back in Michigan, and now tonight, Gekka Holt in the number 27. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for being here, watching this watch this race. If you guys liked it, be sure to give this a like, and if you haven't considered subscribing yet, recommend you do so in order to keep up with some fine content like this coming out in the near future. We will be back next Sunday at the Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. That will be, well, actually, yeah, Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. It was originally supposed to be Mid-Ohio, but we're going to Mosport. That will be on the 7th of May at 12 p.m. Eastern Time. Really hope you guys are able to tune into that race. But until then, thank you guys for watching. Here are your point standings after the second race of the WRLA Pepsi Cup Series. One more time, congratulations to the number 27 of Gekka Holt on winning. And that about does it for us. Have a great night, everybody. We'll see you at Mosport.